exciting to see Waves. Hindi kakayanin yung damage output ng isang Bruno.
Agree. Sobrang masakit yung bola na yon, Butters. Kahit sabihin natin, Raptor Machete and just one attack item lang dito para sa Bruno na to. Talagang kahit sino dito sa members ng Bren Esports, aside from the Uranus, talagang masasaktan.
Mm-hmm. And nakikita nyo naman, nag-start agad dito si Janus doon sa may orange buff niya. Napaka-importante i-note niyan kasi kung iisipin mo, merong malaking chance na uminvade agad yung Bren dito given na sila yung mas stable and mas malakas na zoning potential.
Totoo. And I really like the positioning din kasi nang ginawa doon ng tank and support ng Signal Ultra. No? So most likely nilagyan na ng trap yun ni KK Dot doon so one, kaya mabilis din nakuha nung Bruno. And their positioning, pinuntahan nila kagad yung mga brushes na malapit doon sa may orange buff para masecure agad dito ng Bruno yung kanyang orange buff. Now, I don't think then na Bren Esports have the capability on invading in terms of the hero that they have right now. And Rebo dito, Butters, nagdedelikado dito sa sideline Johed.
And makikita mo naman, ginamit ni Rhea yung flicker niya. And that means meron talagang intent na pauwiin o talagang i-take down etong si Rebo. Ngayon, si Rhea kumuha siya ng toughness boots and that is going to be a way for him para kahit papano mas maging aggressive pa against Rebo Chang'o.
Oo, saka masakit din kasi talaga yung ano, high-end dry jawhead given the smart missile, lalo na kung masolo ka. But speaking of solo, solo si Rhea sa baba, na pick off siya ngayon dito nila Carl TZ.
And dito magiging maganda yung lineup na ginawa ng Bren, yung mga pa-pick off. Mm-hmm. Kasi talagang kailangan lang dito malapitan ni Lusty at matrap lang at manakap lang. And that is going to be a lot of layers ng control para side ng Bren.
Oo, and Bren Esports dito, Butters, but the arrow will connect doon sa may papalit ko. Hindi kasi gano'n ka-confident na sabayan dito ang Bren Esports.
Uy, pero dito si Janus nandun na sa may area, and Carl TZ dito, na wave, na volley of the world, ladies and gentlemen, Carl TZ dito, tatakbo siya, and that's going to be Lusty, going down, Rhea dito with the pick-off. Kanino mapupunta? Kay Rhea mapupunta. Aquaboy dito naghahanap ng proper timing. Tingnan natin kung papasok ba siya. Hindi niya na itutuloy.
And not only that, and Butters, I think Signal Ultra did bounce back yung pick-off doon sa kay Rhea sa may bot lane. Nabawi niya na yon. Kasi nakuha niya yung turtle. He also got a pick-off with Lusty regardless na namatay siya doon. So, Signal Ultra is actually having a great start dito sa ating third game dito against Bren Esports. Now, Bren Esports, they would like to force a reaction ngayon dito for Signal Ultra. Kanina pumasok doon si Carl TC and parang halos na burst down kagad siya ng alahate. Kaya napilitan dito si Few na sumanib sa kanya. Look at the damage of this jawhead. Grabe, even a Uranus muntik pa.
And kung titignan mo kasi meron din high and dry dito si Rhea. So talagang mananakit ang mananakit kapag nalapitan kanya, lalo na kapag 1v1. Ngayon, ang ganda ng pagkakagamit ni Janus doon ng Wave of the World. Mm-hmm. Talagang napalayo niya si Carl TZ and he used it as a utility para hindi malapitan yung mga supports niya. Pwede mo din siya kasing gamitin na ganun eh. Kahit sabihin natin na kapag nag-bound siya sa madami, mas magiging efficient at mas magiging may hit kay max potential niya. Pero kasi, kapag ka na-knockback mo lang, kahit saglit lang, para may breathing room lang yung supports mo para makatakbo, that's perfect for them.
Totoo, yung knockback nun, eh, no? Nung ultimate ng Bruno. And not only that, no? Mapo-force din kasi yung side ng Bren Esports na kahit papano maghiwalay saglit. Kasi you wouldn't want na mag-bounce in, bounce back lang sa inyo yung bola na yon. So now, right now, mga kaibigan, medyo nagkakaroon tayo ng konting stalemate, but it's probably a ticking time man para sa side dito ng Bren Esports. A Signal Ultra might actually have a better late game compared to the draft na yon ng Bren.
Kung nakikita mo dito, in terms of damage output, sila Aquaboy, si Janus, naghahanap lang sila ng way dito para talaga makakuha ng items eh. Mm-hmm. Yun lang inaantay nila. And as long as na-install nila yung game, they are going to be fine with that. Lusty, tinamaan siya ng pana dito pero may purify siya. And kung papasin mo yung lineup ng Bren, meron silang apat na purify dito at isang retribution.
Oo, they wouldn't want eh, na ma-lockdown ng isang jawhead dito. And going back dito, andito, nararamdaman na natin dito yung damage ng isang Bruno Butters.
And Carl TZ try to get away at nandun si Aquaboy! And Shadow Kill, ginamit na pero nandoon sa may minions tumama, Rhea going in. Uranus dito, mauhuli siya. Pero that is a 1-for-2 trade that nakuha si Carl TZ dito, which means walang retribution yung side ng Bren Esports.
Grabe, grabe yung ginawa ni Aqua Boy with the flank on the back lanes dito ng Bren Esports. Nagulo yung kanilang formation. Kumbaga, binabato-bato sila ng bola doon sa may harap. Sabay, nagulat na lang silang bigla na nandun na pala yung Hayabusa. And that resulted a free turtle dito for the side of Signal Ultra. Unti-unti, nakakakuha ng mga objective dito ang Signal. Bren Esports have to think of a way paano ma-halt ang aggression dito ng Signal Ultra.
Binabakil unti-unti si Aqua Boy dito. At isang bala na lang sana. Mm-hmm. Tutumba na siya pero makakataka siya with the quad shadow. At eto ha, nakikita mo kung paano nagiging aggressive sila Janus dito. Janus with the Raptor Machete. Kekidot with the Clock of Destiny. Gaano ka-importante yun, Rob?
Malaki. Malaki ang importance noon kasi in terms of sustainability. I mean, dito kasi sa isang sa Selena, you wouldn't want a damage item. Lalo na kung support ka naman. You're not going for like a Calamity Reaper. Most of the time, Clock of Destiny, susundan nila yan like a Lightning Truncheon. Then probably you go for a Winter Truncheon right after or a Holy Crystal for more damage. Pero in terms of getting the Clock of Destiny, sustain. Kaya nilang i-sustain kahit anong teamfight pa.
Oy, pero sila yung ba DJ dito? Masyadong malalim yung pinasok nila. Holy Baptism is up. Pero habang nangyayari lahat yun, Few gets targeted. And Angela will go down. Aqua Boy dito. Finding the right targets para sa shadow kill.
Anticipated ni Aqua Boy na naghihintay lang doon si Few sa likod na kung kailan siya gagamit ng heart guard. At tapa nice one baby siya nung nakita niya mismo doon si Angela na mag-isa.
And look at this, ladies and gentlemen, Signal Ultra, sila ang nadidictate ng galaw ng tao sa mapa.
Yo, nasa kanila yung yung pacing talaga dito, Butters. Yung tempo nasa Signal Ultra. Not only that, even the gold nasa kanila. And Flap TC still very confident dito. Hindi naman siya dito tinamaan ng pana. Pero I think this jawhead na ginawang sideline dito ng Signal Ultra are really paying off sa kanila dito sa laro na to.
And tingnan natin kung paano lalaban ang Alpha ni Carl TC dito against Janus na meron ng item. Tingnan natin kung mahuhuli ba nila to. Carl TC will get the retribution and that is going to be a win for Bren kahit paano hindi matutuloy ng Signal Ultra yung pagiging aggressive nila at pagti-takedown nila ng turrets.
Yes, I really like the discipline din no, from the side of Signal Ultra. Why? Kasi kung iisipin mo, Butters, pwede nilang i-contest yun eh. I think Aqua Boy was already on the mid lane. Pwede niyang gawin yung ulit yung kanyang pag-flank sa likod. Pero Few, hindi niya nahinintay na umabot na kung kailan lang siya kailangan ni Carl TC. Like kung kailan mawala ng HP, pumasok na siya kagad.
Uh-oh.
Para mas, kumbaga, secured na. At least nandun na ako kagad. Hindi na maulit yung nangyari doon sa may top lane na na-pick up pa siya ng isang Hayabusa. But yeah.
Ang ganda na ginagawa ng Signal Ultra dito, but Bren Esports, they still have a chance to turn this around. Ganito yung nakikita nating mga games na talagang nag-shine yung Bren Esports, but the thing is, parang hindi din nagkakaroon ng pagkakamali yung Signal eh. Kasi wala yung mga openings for Bren eh.
Oo. Ang mahirap pa dito, no, for the side of Bren Esports, it's like they have this Uranus that could potentially hold one isang sideline, pero in terms of mobility, Hayabusa could just turn things around. Pwede siyang lumipat sa top, pwede siyang lumipat sa baba. Kumbaga, there might actually come to a point na baka maging reactive dito ang Bren Esports. And Bren Esports, their draft are very strong when they are together, when they are on fives. Pero Signal Ultra, in terms of mobility, they could probably change their strategy na, wag natin sabayan. Pwede tayong sumegway lang muna tayo and let them get risky plays.
Berserker's Fury.
Mm-hmm.
Now, in the hands of Janus at yung damage output niya ay tumaas lang lalo.
Oh.
Yung critical ng mga volley na iti-take niya, talagang kailangan nyo abangan yan kasi baka makabura yan agad-agad nang hindi nyo napapansin.
Totoo. And given this two mages, Angela and Shanghao dito, they're very squishy dito. Look at that critical, 2,400. Tingin ko, Butters, dalawang ganyan lang kaya nyo na mapatumba kagad dito. Either of the two supports dito ng Bren Esports. And
you know what? Isa pang titignan kong factor dito na kung bakit ang ganda na nakakuha na siya ng Berserker's Fury, pwede nila i-take down agad si Koopa.
Ay, totoo yan.
Pwede nila i-take down agad yung Koopa, mababawasan na isang target at kung ano man yung gusto nilang gawin, it will go doon sa mga heroes at hindi doon sa alaga.
Kumbaga, pwede nilang i-force ng pag-ultimate na kagad yung Popolin Koopa. Kasi medyo malambot yun eh, di ba? Pagka hindi siya naka-ultimate yung aso ni Popol. And yeah, I agree, no? Yung damage output ngayon dito ng Bruno ng Signal Ultra, kumbaga nagiging malaking problema talaga para sa side dito ng Ren Esports. And now, they are eyeing to get the outer turret dito sa my bottom lane. Kumbaga, ang shot call na dito ng Signal Ultra is just to take objective eh, no?
Mm-hmm. And talagang pinipace lang nila yung sarili nila na hindi nila kailangan magmadali. Kasi in terms of scaling naman, you would want Bruno and the Hayabusa na aabot ng late game. Kahit nga isama muna dyan si Rhea ng Johid eh.
Mm-hmm. Exactly, exactly. And I think even kay Kadot is really providing visions dito with this abyssal trap dito. Kung mapapansin mo, both of them traps naman. Pero since the Lord already respond dito, will Brain Esports confident enough to take the Lord since they are very strong na magkakasama sila dito? Are they confident to do it? Pero kung titignan mo, no, Aqua Boy almost get few once again with a shadow kill.
Ito yung mga certain situations na hinahanap talaga nila na pick off lang ang magiging kasanggaan nila dito, and Flap Tizzy, siya ay mapapatalon at nahuli nila dito si Keke Dot. Meron ba siyang dash out and Wave of the World magagamit para isalba si Keke Dot?
Oh no, it's actually very risky, no, na nag-dash in doon yung Selena, not knowing na meron palang mga, andun pala halos lahat ng mga members dito ng Brain Esports. But yes, wala namang casualty for the side of Signal Ultra. Rhea almost get the turret onto the bottom lane. Now Signal Ultra, ito na naman yung Lord dance natin, Butters, the cha-cha effect. Kumbaga, sinusubok-subukan nilang bawasan dito yung Lord para mag-react ang Brain Esports. Ang tanong, tutuluyan yata ng Brain Esports to at kukunin ang Lord.
Sino nga ba mananaig sa retribution battle natin? Angela sumapi na Rhea nandun sa may pinakalikod. Kurt Lizzy na control dito. Rebo will get that Lord and Signal Ultra dito. Napigilan sila. Popoli Koopa is down. Yung pana, hindi tatamaan si Reynos. And that is going to be the stalling mechanics for the side of Brain Esports. Na agaw nila yan. Now, pwede nilang gamitin yung pang stall at pwede nilang gamitin yung para maging aggressive.
Pwedeng-pwede talaga. Pero ang gusto kong itanong sa iyo, Batos, anong meron kay Rebo? Bakit back-to-back nakaka-steal sila ng Lord? Yung Kagura niya kanina, ngayon naman yung kanyang Chango. Wow! On point talaga dito si Doc Rebo, mga kaibigan. This Lord might potentially get defended pa rin naman para sa side dito ng Brain Esports, or rather ng Signal Ultra. Tingin ko naman, they just want to clean. They just want to choke out Signal Ultra. Kung papansin mo, Carl TC, nandun siya sa top lane. Kumbaga, hindi nila sinasabayan yung Lord. They just want to take the map. Kumbaga, gusto lang muna nilang paliitin ang mapa ng Signal Ultra.
Tatandaan mo, yung sinitinanong mo sa akin question, baka goat yan. Baka goat yan. The greatest of all time.
Greatest indeed of all time dito. Doc Rebo getting that Lord. Kumbaga, lampas pa siya sa mga retribution ng kanyang mga jungler eh. Kumbaga, what is retry if you have Rebo?
What diba? Is retry paper only?
Diba?
Hindi, pero alam mo, si Rebo kasi, sabihin na lang natin na yung damage output niya, perfect talaga pang steal yes. ng Lord. Ngayon, kung iisipin mo yung Meteor Shower, tuloy-tuloy na damage siya, constant damage siya for a certain amount of seconds, si Janus at si Karl, hindi nila nagamit yung, retribution nila, pero dahil nga may pressure dun sa may mapa, talagang hindi mo mapipihit yon at the perfect time kapag ka meron na
pressure sa'yo.
Agree. Kumbaga, yung ano, may anxiety ka din, eh, no? Kung itutuloy mo, kung baka kasi ma-out of position ka. And yeah, pero so far dito, mga kaibigan, na even out ng Brain Esports dito, yung aggression, pero still, ah, we are still looking at a Bruno that potentially might actually go into a very late game with a complete item. Nakita na natin to from time and time again. Bruno, pagka nag-complete yung item yan, sobrang sakit. Pero and almost, Aqua Boy, pero sa likod ah, Flap TC.
Pwede yung matakedown to and a shadow kill para makatakas, pero babalik siya doon sa may ilalim. And that's going to be Aqua Boy going down. Sobrang successful nung naging pick-off na pinaplano dito ng Brain Esports. Signal Ultra, kumuha naman sila ng turret doon sa may bottom lane.
Yes, ang naging trade na lang doon is the outer turret on the bottom lane. And a very unfortunate, no, na pick-off doon si Aqua Boy. This mid inner turret dito ng Signal Ultra mukhang ipo-force ngayon dito ng Brain Esports. So somehow, in terms of gold, I think sobrang dikit, or rather it's on the side of Bren Esports, pero mukhang we're really looking in a very late game dito, Butters, or probably another Lord na magiging point of contention of both of the teams as both of them are trying to get their vision on the map.
Ako, titignan ko talaga dito, Lord na lang eh. Yung 60 mm-hmm. seconds na yan, napaka-importante niyan para kay Lusty at kay Kekedot. Yung mga traps nila, kung saan nila ipipwesto yan, it will give them information. Kapag nakuha nila information na yon, dun magde-decide ng pwesto yung team nila. Pwestuhan na ang laban dito kung papaano ka magse-secure ng tamang Lord take.
Oo. Ang problema kasi, no, for the side of Signal Ultra in terms of teamfight, wala silang definite burst eh para sa Alpha that could just simply put them down, like probably a Lunox na pwede siyang tunawin agad-agad. Yes, may damage dito yung Marksman, pero given that the support na manggagaling from the Angela and meron pang meteor shower na kadalasan eh sinasabay pagka sumusugod sila dito nila Carl TZ, in terms of teamfight talaga dito, Bren Esports, I think they are on the upper hand. Pero in terms of mechanically pag-ikot sa teamfight, Signal Ultra, they could probably outmaneuver dito ang side ng Bren Esports. Ginagawa yun ni Aqua Boy sa likod. One of the reason kung bakit kailangan din nakadikit yung Angela sa kanyang jungler, or probably with the Papalenko pa, kasi pwede siyang ma-pick off. Hindi siya pwede yung sobrang nasa likod lang, yung solo-solo siya.
Mm-hmm. And while you were talking, Rob, dag up na ang ating Luminous Lord. Tingnan natin dito kung ano ang gagawin ng both teams. Kung napapansin mo, si Aqua nandun siya sa may taas.
Mm-hmm.
Sinusubukan niya i-shove yung lane doon pababa sa side ng Bren. Alam nila na kapag may nag-auto-push na lane para sa kanila, that is going to be a big advantage if ever man ma-takedown etong turret na to at mabuksan yung base ng Bren Esports.
Oo, ganun eh. Ganun, kumbaga parang nagkakapaan na lang sila dito, Butters eh. And I really agree, no, na hindi nila pwedeng basta-bastang iwan doon si Aqua Boy sa may top lane. That's one of the reason why Flat TC has to man him out. Kumbaga they would be fighting for like a 4v4 situation sa may Lord if in case na mangyari yon at maiwan si Hayabusa and as well itong Uranus na mag 1-on-1. Now, Bren Esports are trying to poke the Lord. Will they want to go with it since baka maiba na naman yung story. Mm-hmm. At kanina, nakuha nila yung Lord pero naubos naman sila. And game number 3, you wouldn't want to happen that once again.
Mm-hmm. Now, the Lord take is onto the side of, sabihin na lang natin, Bren, sila yung nakapwesto ng tama dito, while the side of Signal Ultra, sila yung nagpaplano ng recapture nung area na yan. At sinusubukan talaga nila magkaroon ng re-entry dito, but still, yung Lord, bumababa na yung buhay. Lastly dito, will be the target, Carl TZ. Ginamitan ng Heart Guard and the damage output na nanggagaling dito sa members sa side ng Signal Ultra. And this is going to be an all-out team fight. Bren Esports gets the Lord. Janus dito, pinipirit nila Pew. And Rhea will go down. Janus will go down as well. Imba DJ dito, pinipilit i-heal si Keke Dot. Silang dalawa ang tumatakbo dito at silang dalawa ang buhay. Pero si Aqua Boy din dito, nasa area siya. Pwede siyang kumuha ng pick-off dito. Meron siyang shadow kill. Paano niya gagamitin to?
Yon ang malaking tanong, kung paano niya gagamitin. Hindi rin siya makakita ng opportunity dahil dikit-dikit din talaga yung mga members dito ng Bren Esports. Alam nila, nangyari na yon kanina. Yun, na-force out na lang dito si Aqua Boy na gamitin yung kanyang shadow kill just to clear the wave on the mid lane para hindi sila ma-pressure na magkakasabay lahat na darating yung mga minion dito ng Bren Esports. But still, Bren Esports securing that Lord with Carl TZ.
Kekedot, Imba DJ, sila ang naatasan na mag-defend dito sa may taas. Pero wala silang damage. Kailangan nila si Aqua Boy. Janus dito lumabas with a superhero dash.
Oo. I like how Carl, itong yung pag-zone out eh. I think doon sa team fight, sa Lord pit na yun, sinown out sila doon ni Lusty together with Flap TC. Umabot doon sa point na na-out-sustain na nung Uranus dito yung damage ni Janus, and he's actually been picked off from that third or for that Lord fight. So now we're back to square one dito. Butter is defended, walang base turret sa taas, pero still Bren Esports, they're very disciplined. Ayaw nilang pilitin na kunin pa yung mga ibang base turrets dito ng Signal Ultra, and probably we might actually have to wait for another Lord.
And mas naging, sabihin na lang natin, aggressive dito yung Bren in terms of positioning. Tignan mo kung saan sila ngayon.
Mm-hmm.
Nasa jungle sila nung kalaban. And si Carl TZ nga, nag-iisa dito sa my orange side. So ibig sabihin talaga, yung confidence ng brand bumalik na dito, two lords na punta sa kanila. And to be honest, ang dami ng times na pwede sanang tapusin ng Signal Ultra to kung nakukuha nila yung lord. But every single time na ipipilit nila, Brand Esports ang nakakuha.
Oo. That lord, that two lords na nanggaling from Brand Esports are really paying off sa kanila dito. Look at the meteor shower. Grabe yung damage kung Chango.
Oh my goodness, look at that. Si Rhea dito natumba, pero ito, Wave of the World will hit two people, pero that's not going to be enough damage. Si Lusty dito nahuli ng pana, pero that's way too risky. Ando na si Ribo sa area.
Oh no, look at that positioning from Flap PC. Ganun siya, grabe yung confidence niya dito. Alam niya na hindi siya kayang i-burst down, even that with yung luck item na isang Bruno. Now, mukhang mauubos na ngayon ang base turret dito ng Signal Ultra. Konti na lang Butters at mawawala na ng mga tore dito ang Signal. And they will be on defensive mode. Kahit sabihin na natin maghihintayin pa tayo ng susunod na lord, mas mahihirapan sila ngayong lumabas ng kanilang base.
Kumuha na ng halberd dito si ano?
Mm-hmm.
Si Aqua Boy. Ito na.
Kailangan
nila laban sa ano? Laban kay Flap, kailangan na kailangan nila. Pero Imba DJ dito, kinain nga yung ultimate dito ni Ribo. And Ribo just dealing so much damage. Keke dot dito, dash in, dash out. Janus trying to take down etong si Popol. Pero, ay si Koopa. But still, fact remains, basag pa rin yung turrets dito ng Signal Ultra. And the only turret na meron sila dito is going to be the base turret.
Exactly. Kanina, ito rin, ay rather on the second game, ito rin yung mismong gumana for the side of Signal Ultra. This Uranus, one of the reason bakit pinriority ng Bren ang pagpick na to. Kasi they know na ganito yung mangyayari, na kaya nilang sabayan, na kayang isustain nila dito yung mga magiging damage given na makuha pa nila yung Rafaela Bruno. The Brunella nga, ika nga dito. And now Butters, once again, nabuhay na naman dito si Lord. And looking at the position dito ng Bren, they would want to take it now.
Oh my goodness, and this goes down the line, ladies and gentlemen. Signal Ultra, paano nila i-contest tong Lord na to? Kailangan nila to para mapigilan ang pagkapanalo ng Bren Esports. And Janus dito, getting knocked up. Janus, nasa kita ng lahat. Imba DJ, hindi niya kaya isalba yung kanyang jungler doon. Carl TZ trying to chase them down. Carl TZ dito with the help of you, mazo-zone nila yung mga tao dito sa side ng Signal. At yung Signal dito, kahit pa paano yung minions sila nakikipagkapit bisig.
Oo.
Nag-takedown ng turret dun sa may mid.
Exactly. Na-shove nila yung mid lane, kaya medyo matagal mag-a-approach yung Lord dito. Pero Butters, this is level 3 Lord. Not only that, wala silang tore dito. They don't have a very clear minion wave. So ngayon, ito ang magiging problema. Paanong depensa ang gagawin dito ng Signal Ultra?
Kailangan nila lumaban sa labas, kasi pag hindi, mag-charge yung Lord na yan papunta doon sa base nila. At yun yung ginagawa nila ngayon. Tignan natin yung damage output dito. Pew with the heart guard, pinipilit nila i-take na si Carl TZ dito, but the damage is way too much. And that is going to be Bren Esports getting